Hello and welcome to a very special How I Paint Things quick tips. What we're going to do today is a very quick video on how I've achieved Deathwing. It is Deathwing? I always get Deathwing and Raven Guard mixed up somehow. But Dark Angel's Deathwing armor, they have this bone tone for all of their Terminators. And I think it looks pretty cool. It's a real nice way to break up some of that dark coloration in the army. It can be quite daunting, especially because on the box they tend to be very crisp, but it's not actually that difficult to achieve something that looks pretty good by comparison. And once all the details are painted in, you know, you will hardly notice the difference. So let's get straight into it. Nice quick look at how we're going to get this bone color. Now to begin with, we're actually going to use just three colors for the basis of this armor. I've started off by giving them a spray of Corax White, which gives us a nice smooth base coat to work off. And then we're going to give them a couple of thin coats of Screaming Skull. Now, if you happen to have access to Army Painter's sprays, then pick up some Skeleton Bone, I think is the name of it, and you can skip these two steps. All right, it's a nice base coat, and it will give you pretty much exactly the same color. So if you do happen to have that handy, go pick it up, especially if you're going to be doing a lot of Deathwing. At any rate, once we've got that done, we're actually going to dry brush our edges with Praxedi White. Now the reason why this is because ordinarily I would use something like Tyrant's Skull to go over as a bone color. But the problem is, Tyrant's Skull is actually darker than Screaming Skull. So what we're going to need to do is go brighter. So we'll use Praxedi White. Now I'm using this over Rack White because Rack White has a slightly kind of peachy, fleshy tone to it. And it's not really what we want to look for. I want a nice crisp white for this. Then over that, we're going to carefully shade in with some Sarah from Sepia. We're still going to go over the whole model, same as we would with anything else, but instead of just bucketing it on, we're going to be a little bit more select about how it goes on. So, first things first, let's get this Screaming Skull on. Now, this bit is not terribly complicated. I've got just a little bit of water in my brush, and we'll go on now and start painting in all of the armor with Screaming Skull. You might find, and I will probably do this myself, you'll want to go over for a second thin coat of this because you'll see that there are just a few areas where it doesn't cover perfectly. But either way, let's get this on now. Now after my second coat of Screaming Skull, this is what we've got. It looks a little bit darker in reality, but it is quite bright. You know, you're going to be hard pressed to find a color that is brighter than this. So what I've got here is my Praxedi White. I've got a small dry brush, and we're just going to do the usual, load up with paint, and then scrub most of it off on some old kitchen towel. Okay, we'll get the edge of our base, get an idea of how much we're going to leave behind. I might actually want a little bit more back on the brush there. But what you want to do is look for any hard edges. So along the top of his armor here is a pretty good spot to start. And you're just going against those areas. What you want to do is pick out those bits where the brush is going to catch, and you're going to leave that white behind. Now let me just shift this. It might be a little bit easier to see what it's doing on there, but what you're looking for is go around the whole model, and just any of these hard edges, go ahead and hit them with a little bit of Praxedi White. Now after our Praxedi White, this is what we've got. It might be a little bit difficult to see, but it's not too hard to do. Okay, all you're looking to do is sort of chalk up the edges and give it a little bit of depth. You know, we want that three-dimensional effect where the white is right at the edges of all the detail. So I've got here my Seraphim Sepia and medium shade brush. What I'm going to do now is go over the whole model, but instead of just right on top of the thing, like I normally would, I'm going to be a little bit more careful. I am still going to apply it to the whole model like this, but when it comes to, you know, how much of it I want to pull, I really want to be able to draw it away from anywhere that it's going to get kludgy. You know, I don't want too much of it in any one place. So you're almost painting this on a bit more like a layer paint. So let's go around and over the whole model. When you come to one section, you want to try and finish that area in one go rather than coming back, because you might find you get some strange kind of tide marks if you do it that way. Now, after about half an hour, our shade is dried, and this is what we're left with. Now, you might be forgiven for asking, what was the point of that Rack White? Praxedi White. And the answer is, honestly, it does change up things a little bit towards the edges. But where I said, you know, you can go a little overboard with it, I really mean it. There isn't too much white dry brushing over that. But you'll see, it's given us that nice deep shade again, and it looks a little closer to that sort of bone color that we've got on the box. But it's still just a little bit dark. Once we've gone and put on the wash, it does bring it down quite a bit. So there is an optional step here. I've got here my screaming skull again and a large dry brush. What I'm going to do is use it exactly the same way as we would the dry paints. You know, I've actually been asked, can you dry brush with normal paints? And yeah, of course. But if you're coming to this for the first time, that might not be obvious. So what you got to do is prep up your brush the same way you would ordinarily, you know, wipe most of it off, and we'll start near the edges. There we go. And just start bringing up all over the model. You don't need to be too careful, but what you want to do is particularly catch the edges and get that nice sharp bone color towards the edge. But if you do end up going over, say, some of the back area and brightening it up a little bit more than the rest, it doesn't matter too much. Okay, so I'm going to go around now over the whole model with some screaming skull and just bring it up a little again and see what we're left with. Now, what I've done is after the first dry brush, I've actually gone over with another very light one and just brought out that color a little bit more. So rather than being just the edges, I've used it to buff out that bone color a fair bit and make it a little bit more even across the whole model. And I quite like how that's turned out. So what I could do now would be to go in and fill in all of the other areas. So maybe warpstone glow for the green, Mephiston red for those red details. Metal in the way you normally would. I would probably use Rakarth flesh for the purity seals on this guy so that they stand out a little bit more from the armor itself. I'm going to skip over those though, because honestly, the point of this is really to do more of just a quick tip. So this is how I would paint the armor. The rest of the details, that's really up to you guys, how you like them to look. It's not perfect, it's not the smoothest out there, but again, that's not really the point of what I'm trying to do with these things. This is just easy to replicate. And I think it looks pretty good. So as ever, guys, if anything was helpful to you there, you know, feel free to drop a comment in the old box below. I'm getting back in the swing of things. There was a bit of a lull, and you know, unfortunately, I got called away on an unexpected journey, let's say. So that does sort of color the context of what the next video is going to be. Maybe look forward to that one. But like I said, hopefully this is helpful to you. And as ever, guys, thank you very much for your time. You enjoy the rest of your day.